Check that out. Rock and roll royalty here at the new Gary Casino in Indiana. That guitar is Joe Jackson's guitar. It's the one that his kids broke when he was at work one day. He fixed it. He asked them, show me what you've been working on. And then there you have it, the beginning of the Jackson 5. So that's what's going on here. They have tons of other memorabilia, which I'm going to show you in a second. Talk to the curator of all the memorabilia, as well as two members of the Jackson family, Tito and Marlon. Doing that now for the Chicago scene here in Indiana. Now, before I say goodbye to this part of the video, check that out. There is a guitar above my head that leads all the way to the Jackson 5 exhibit down there. Pretty cool, huh? And here are some of the examples of all the fun gear that they have here at the new Hard Rock Casino. I'm here with Giovanni. How are you, sir?
I'm doing very well. And yourself?
I'm great. So the things right behind you there, that's all on you. You're the collector for this incredible space and other properties in the Hard Rock family, right?
That's correct.
So tell me exactly, like, you know, some of the things that people can expect when they come here. What should they be looking for?
I think guests will be able to see a wide range of artists on display. You know, anyone that's been back in the 50s, you know, Elvis Presley, all the way to modern day with Billie Eilish, Post Malone, and everything in between. There's something for everyone.
And I mean, obviously the highlight here is the Jackson family. Talk about how you know, received some of that stuff and where it's displayed in the casino.
So yeah, we decided that we wanted to do a very locally relevant story here. So Gary, Indiana is the home of the Jackson 5, and the entire Jackson family, I should say.
And that's the whole draw of the casino being here as well, right? I mean, that whole tie-in, it was a good spot for that as well.
That's a big part of it, yes. And there's research to show how interconnected the entire industry is. But it wasn't just focused on the Jacksons, because we also have Bristol, Talaferro, Kim Mazzell, Denise Williams, the Kinsey brothers.
You know, the modern, like Fall Out Boy and other things, Stick.
Display here, you know. So we wanted to tell as well a very locally relevant story, both for Gary, Indiana, as well as Indiana specific, with Kenny Aronoff, with John.
Oh, yeah, Mellencamp's drummer. Yeah.
Axl Rose, you know.
That's right. He's from
Lafayette.
Yeah.
Shannon Hoon as well, you know. So we wanted to make sure that we're representing Indiana in general. Stories that maybe artists that aren't from Gary but have a tie-in in some way to Gary. The Beatles.
So the Beatles. Tell.
Yeah, the Beatles' very first release was, U.S. release, I should say, was released on VJ Records, which started here in Gary, Indiana.
Did it really? I did not know that.
So we have, you know, from the Beatles, we have a suit that John Lennon wore. We have a Grammy Award from the one that they won in 64 as the best new artist after they released that album on VJ. We also have George Harrison's personal tour itinerary, as well as a marked up flight path from that tour. You can see the hurricane in, you know, scribbled in there. It's pretty fun. But also, if you look at the map, you know, you can see the city of Gary right on that map. So, you know, you can see the flight plan.
Yeah, I mean, the city of Gary has gone through several transformations over the years, but back in the Beatles days, when they were new, I mean, this is a big steel town. There's a lot of people coming through here. It's the bridge between Detroit and Chicago. How do you go about getting all of the memorabilia that you have, just not here but anywhere? Is it?
Sometimes you go straight to the artist, and if you have the personal contacts, you know, the Jackson family, we met with them in South Florida about 16 months ago, 17 months ago. We presented them with some of the stuff that we already had in the collection, which, you know, as you heard earlier, they were all about, you know, I remember this, you know, it was the first time I've seen it since I wore it type of thing. But additionally, one special piece that we got directly from Tito is his dad's guitar. It was Joseph Jackson's 61 Airline Town and Country. And that guitar is the guitar that Tito broke a string on when he was 10 years old, trying to learn how to play.
When Dad was at work, right?
Exactly. And that ultimately is what created the Jackson 5. That guitar alone is what started the Jackson 5. Because had Joseph not seen the broken string and got a little upset, obviously, because that was his prized possession. But once he restrung it, he handed it to Tito and he said, show me what you got. And then Tito just, you know, started. He just started playing. Jermaine and Jackie got up, started singing, and the rest is history.
And the birth, that was the birth of the Jackson 5 right there. That's an incredible story. And I, you know, it's funny, I love music and I've been a part of the music industry, and I have never heard that story told until today. So hence why you see that big guitar I don't know what you call it, the display from right when you walk into the building leading to the Jackson 5 exhibit right there, right?
And that guitar outside is a replica of the real guitar that we have here at Gary.
Yeah, and it's fun. You guys do a lot of fun things here with the smashing of the guitars outside right in front of that historic guitar. And it leads you right into the middle of the casino where the exhibit's there, where their full costumes are there. And then you got Michael's, his original bad jacket, the glove, the shoes, the moonwalk shoes. This place is awesome. You guys have done an amazing job with the collection you have, including the Paul Stanley and the Van Halen gods behind you right now.
Oh, yeah. And it's not, and this is one thing that we want everyone to understand. We're not all about one genre of music. We celebrate all forms of music. You know, because rock and roll to us is just the umbrella that captures all genres and styles. If you think about the way rock and roll was created, it was the big bang from the merger of blues, jazz, country, pop, R&B, gospel.
Muscle Shoals coming up north to Chicago to blues.
So that's the way we are now. It's that we celebrate all of it. And so we have Tupac here. We have Beyonce here. We have, you know, Jimmy Reed. We have the Kinsey Report. We have Gwen Stefani. We have, as I mentioned, Billie Eilish and Post Malone. We have Lady Gaga. We have Justin Timberlake. We have Diana Ross. I mean, it could go on and on.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but your collection as a whole is the biggest one in the world, right? For rock and roll and music memorabilia, right?
That's correct. It's the largest music and entertainment memorabilia collection in the world with 86,000 pieces.
And is it like all in one spot where you get to go and just kind of walk through this treasure trove of amazing memorabilia and go, all right, this would be good for this space, this would be good for that space?
We do have a warehouse that's in the hidden deep swamps of South Florida with alligators guarding it. But that's where the centralized collection rests that aren't on current display within any property worldwide.
Well, I appreciate you digging through some of those archives, bringing them out here and doing the work to getting some of that priceless memorabilia from the Jackson family to the Ed Sheeran stuff, the Justin Timberlake, Malone. This is awesome. So thank you for your time and thank you for what you're doing for Gary and
Young. I truly appreciate it. Thank you for having me.
No problem.
All right, so I'm here with some of the Jackson family. How are you guys, Marlon and Tito? How's it going?
We're doing fine. We're going great. Everything is going great. It's
very
great
exciting
to be.
Day.
Yeah, it was great to be back in Gary, Indiana.
Yeah, I mean, we're just a couple of miles away from the house that you guys grew up in, and who would have thought a broken guitar would lead to where we are right now, standing here?
I know, and that's something. I mean, we're just thankful that Hot Rock has stepped in and took a chance on Gary. Because when I say thankful and blessed, because that's going to generate revenue to the city of Gary, Indiana. And that's what it's about, creating jobs. Because we've been through a tough year. This is the beginning of something that's going to be great in Gary.
Growing up in Gary, like, what were some of, I mean, aside from playing with your family, like, what else, just being from the Midwest or being from Gary, is special to you guys and what you've taken through your entire careers and lives?
Tito?
Just growing up here, and what makes Gary a fantastic place is the people and the heart that they have for each other. And that's what I remember, friends and other relatives, cousins, and things
playing
of that
baseball.
Nature, playing Little League
playing
baseball.
Playing baseball?
Yeah, he played Little League baseball. Jackie and Jermaine.
I was on a baseball team by the name of Cats Kittens.
Oh, yeah?
It was basically the mayor's team, Mayor Cats. And his baseball was Cascading, so I got to do that one year.
Yeah. What position?
I played second base.
Yeah. Yes. Did the family come out and watch you play, or was it kind of you did it on your own thing?
All the time.
Oh, yeah?
No, yes.
Because it's right behind our house. So we
really?
Go just right there. Yeah, I mean, directly,
I
right
mean,
behind our house.
No,
the
further
field.
Than from here to that restroom sign.
Yeah.
Very close.
That's how the baseball field is.
And, you know, you guys have gone on to do things that most families would, you know, dream about. So what does it mean as the legacy of the Jackson family to have this casino with all of your memorabilia in here, your house down the street? What's that mean for you guys, just as the rock and roll legacy that you're leaving?
Well, it feels good to know that others recognize your work, and we don't take it for granted. It's a blessing. And we thank them for their support throughout the years.
Yeah, and this shows the appreciation that not only the Hard Rock, but the city of Gary, the people of Gary, the support that they've given you throughout your career, and to come back and put this place here and be a part of the memorabilia and other identities of the Hard Rock. It's a great thing because people pass through here every day and they get to stop and see your accomplishments.
What I do want to mention also is that, you know, yesterday we had an unveiling of the new signs that's going to be going throughout Gary, directing them to 2300 Jackson Street, and working on passing the bill with it. Well, 2300 Jackson Street will become a historical site, and then there's some other plans coming. So it's a great day. Things are happening here in Gary, Indiana. And we thank everybody. Come in the casino and enjoy yourself and look at the memorabilia that they have of the family around here.
Yeah, congratulations to you guys. It's a great way for us to begin to get out of this pandemic with the beautiful sunshine, this beautiful building, and a memorabilia all around. So congratulations to the Jackson family.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Take care.
All right, that's going to wrap up the opening festivities here on this opening weekend. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. As always, thank you for watching and enjoy the music.